Our first contestant from ABBT. Sarima Moshidi, up there, down here. Sarima Moshidi, up there, down here.
It was a very sunny morning. The time was about 10 a.m. I was dressed in a t-shirt, a season t-shirt, and a worn-out jeans, and with only one old bag with me. I was left alone by the roadside on the suburb of Ipoh Perak. Ladies and gentlemen, all of us in life, that we experience certain incidents that we will never forget. And those incidents that provide us or lead us to become a better person. And because of that incident, what happened to me? And I'm thankful. Because when I was left alone by the roadside with nothing, and I was trying to get myself back all the way from Penang Dam to Perak, all the way back to Sarawak, my hometown. I don't have any money. Imagine you left alone there with no one. And this happened way before I joined Postmasters. Then what happened? I walk. The sun was really excruciating. I can feel the heat on my skin. And I, from not very far, I saw a stall, and I decided, maybe I should stop there and seek for a job. I did well there, and spoke to this very nice stall lady, and I was asking her whether if I can get a job, because I need to save some money for me to go back to my hometown. She was kind, but she said, I'm sorry, we don't have any vacancy. I was already feeling very hungry, and I told her, is it possible if I were to work here, you don't have to give me any money. It's sufficient for me if you just give me lunch for that day. And looking at my sad condition, she was very kind to give me that opportunity to work, not for money, but to work for food. And after that, before I start doing the chores, she gave me ice cold milk drink. And after I finish, I immediately go to the kitchen. She asked me to wash all the dishes. While I was washing all the pots and pans, all the cups and pans, everything, and I heard the store lady was saying to this old guy, poor girl. She was left alone on the road. She's looking for money for her to go back. And this old guy, about 60 years of age, look at him and was like, don't worry, child. Let me go to the nearest school. So he went on his motorbike. I was so touched by his kindness. And not long after that, about 15 minutes, then he came back. And then he told me, child, there is an opening, but it will be in another two months' time. And I was so touched, I was saying, I'm so sorry, I cannot wait for 2 months. Because I have to collect as I go along. So it's not something permanent that I'm looking for. That is the kind gesture of this old man. And while I was also doing the dishes, and the coffee guy asked me, Sarima, please serve in front. So I did. So I went and served. And while I served, and this guy was, the guy that I served, he was looking at me like, from top to toe. And he was saying, Niwa. I said, yes. Okay. He was saying that. But he has this sarcastic look. And then I just put the drink, and I said, thank you, and then and I went back to do the dishes. And then not long after that, another fellow, because they are so supportive of me, they wanted to help me in this store what's happening. They wanted to help me. So there was this guy at the back of the store. He was laying there, and there were two other guys sitting there. And he was saying, I heard that you want to looking for a job. He was saying. And I said, yes. If I give you a job, are you willing to stay here and not run away? With very authoritative voice. And I was like, I would consider it, sir. Then I, because of his nature of behavior, I decided not to converse so long with him. It's rather to stand down rather than to be looked down by him. Then I continued with my teachers. Ladies and gentlemen, there are times in life, there are so many people out there. If you are up there, then you might want to look down or be looked down upon. And if you are down there, then you tend to look up for those up there, people up there who are so successful. I felt for the last 3 hours that I have there, I work not for money, for food. I was being scrutinized from top to bottom, like a CSI, and CSI analysis. And I was even looked down. Ladies and gentlemen, those 3 hours experience was actually a real life training experience for me when I was at my previous organization. But I cannot reveal that I was in training. But these are the experiences that I have without all those people knowing who I was then, at what level I was in the corporate world, or at how high, or what is your qualification in terms of your degree. They don't know that. They just accept you for who you are. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, when you're up there, please consider people who are down there. Thank you very much. Thank you.